Dear Mirae Asset Investors, my name is Ruli, and I'm the Head of Research and Chief Economist at Mirae Asset Sekuritas Indonesia. Next year is projected to be more challenging and uncertain, leading to a potentially higher market volatility, particularly in early 2025. Consequently, the Bank Indonesia, or BI, will have a very limited room to cut policy rates. The global growth in 2025 is expected to remain flat at 3.2%, with increasing divergence among countries. The US growth is anticipated to slow to 2.2%, down from 2024's expectation of 2.8%, but it will still outpace peers such as the Euro area and Japan. The strong US GDP growth will present both opportunities and challenges. On the positive side, Indonesia's exports to the US, a major trade partner, may increase. On the downside, the US inflation may exceed expectations, potentially leading to higher US policy rates than previously expected. The US dollar is likely to remain strong, supported by robust economic performance and elevated interest rates, accompanied by rising the US Treasury yields. The rupiah performance next year will likely to mirror other currencies, heavily influenced by US interest rates trends. The speculation of less aggressive Federal Reserve rate cuts will exert pressure on global currencies, including the rupiah, against the US dollar. The rupiah pressure is likely to persist through the first half of 2025, which will influence the BI's monetary policy decisions. BI is expected to hold its policy rate to stabilize rupiah and prevent significant foreign portfolio outflows. Assuming rupiah stability improves in the second half of next year, the BI may gain more flexibility in its monetary policy. Despite recent market volatilities, Indonesia's economic indicators remain relatively healthy and stable. Inflation is under control within BI target range of 1.5 to 3.5%, supported by a sound external and also fiscal balance. Inflation has moderated faster than expected, driven by robust food supplies and subdued commodity pressures. Household consumption grew steadily at 4.5% year-on-year in the third quarter of 2024, reflecting stable consumer purchasing power supported by easing inflation. On the other hand, GDP growth in Indonesia slowed to 4.95% year-on-year in the third quarter of 2024, primarily due to sharp 11.5% year-on-year increase in imports of capital goods and raw materials. However, household consumption, the largest GDP component, remained stable at 4.9% year-on-year, suggesting resilient consumer spending amid stable inflation. Stable economic growth supported corporate performance in 9 months 2024, despite challenges. The consumer and retail sectors demonstrated resilience, achieving high single-digit revenue growth on average. In the telecommunications sector, consolidation remains a key driver for the growth in telco and tower companies. The new government under Prabowo and Gibran, in collaboration with the central bank's monetary policies, will continue to explore opportunities to adopt accommodative measures aimed at maintaining stability of Indonesia's macroeconomic conditions. We anticipate next year's growth will remain steady at 5%. Dear Mirae Asset Investor, thank you for your attention. Terima kasih. My name is Ruli Arya Wisnubroto, I'm the head of research and chief economist at Mira Asset Sekuritas Indonesia. Thank you.